Namaste students, this is for grade 10 students. Subject is English. There are totally 7 units in our English book. Each unit has a prose, a poem and a supplementary. From 7 poems, 4 are memory poems. We must recite all the 4 memory poems because choices will not be given in question paper. Today we are going to learn unit 1 memory poem Life. Before going to learn, we can learn about biography of author. The poem Life was written by Henry Van Dyke. He was born in 1852 and died in 1933. He was an American author, poet, educator and clergyman. Clergyman, it means male priest or religious leader. He served as a professor of English literature at Princeton University between 1899 and 1923. He also was elected to the American Academy of Arts and Letters and received many other honors. It is a sonnet. The word sonnet is derived from the Italian word sonetto, which means a little song or small lyric. In poetry, a sonnet has 14 lines and is written in iambic pentameter. Iambic pentameter, it means a line with 10 syllables accented on every second beat. For example, first notice the line, "Let me but live my life from year to year." Count those words. There are 10 words in this line. In this line, me, live, life, year and another year are stressed and other words are unstressed. This is called iambic pentameter. The first 8 lines of a sonnet is known as octave and last 6 lines is known as sestet. Sonnets can be categorized on the basis of live my life from year to year, with forward face and unreluctant soul. Here, the poet wants to give advice to the reader through this poem by his personal experience. The poet wants to live his life in a happy manner. He wants to live a joyful life. He wants to live an enjoyable life. He wants to live his life every year with a joyful heart, with forward face and unreluctant soul. He is ready to face all the situation in a positive manner. Unreluctant, it means willing to do something. He is ready to move towards the future with the plenty of positivity. Next, look at the third line in first stanza. Not hurrying to, not turning from the goal. The poet does not like to hurry or haste in any matters or situation. He does not want to turn away from his aims or goals. Whatever it is, he is ready to face with the confidence and hope. Not mourning for the things that disappear. Mourning, it means feeling or expressing sadness. He does not want to be a sad person if anything missing. He does not feel sad if anything happened negatively in his life. Through this 4 lines of the poem, the poet wants to say us, we should enjoy our life year to year. We should ready to face anything with a positive manner. We should not hurry for anything and should not give up our hope. Whatever it is, we should ready to face with the confidence and hope. Should not show your worrying or sadness for anything disappear. Fifth line of first stanza. In the dim past, nor holding back in fear from what the future veils. Dim past, it means dull past. He does not want to think about his dull past. And also, he does not want to think about his future. Here, future veils. Veils, it means to hide or cover something that you cannot see or it clearly or understand it. Future veils. We should not know about the future. What will happen in the future? We don't know. Then why we should fear about the future? From these two lines, the poet says he does not want to think about the dull past and also he does not worry about the future. But with old and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. He wants to live his life with a happy heart. He wants to enjoy his life like a child. Here the poet says life is a journey. He likes to travel his journey of life cheerfully. Just now we can recall a first stanza of our memory poem. The poet wants to live his life very happily in every year. And he is ready to face anything and everything in a positive way. He is willing to do all the things for his happy future. And he does not want to hurry or haste for doing the things. And he does not want to turn away his goal. He wants to continue his goal with confidence and hope. And he does not feel sad if anything happened negatively in his life. And he does not want to think about the dull past. And also not worrying about the future, what we don't know which will happen. He wants to live his whole life with a happy heart. He wants to live his life like a child in a sense. He likes to travel his life journey with the second stanza, first line. So let the way wind up the hill or down, over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Therefore, it does not matter to poet whether the path goes up or down the hill, rough or smooth, the journey will be joyful. The only thing to the author is he wants to enjoy his life. No matter whatever happens, if his path is difficult or easy, he will make it a joyful journey. Next, third line of second stanza. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. New friendship, high adventure and a crown. In this line, he says that he is searching a new friends. What he was searching when he was a boy, now he is searching his friends like this way. He is getting new experience and he is expecting a new adventure which enrich him. The next lines are, my heart will keep the courage of the quest and hope the road's lost tone will be the best. Life is not as an entity but as an experience. We should live our life with courage, dedication and a clear sense of purpose. Here the poet wants to seek a purposeful life with courage and determination. The poet encourages us to have faith and determination in our hearts as we take on this beautiful journey. He hopes that every turn of our life journey will be the best. This is the summary of the poem, students. Now listen and repeat the poem line by line. Let me but live my life from year to year with forward face and unreluctant soul. Not hurrying to, not turning from the goal. Not mourning for the things that disappear. In the dim past, nor holding back in fear from what the future veils, but with a whole. And happy heart that pays it toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. Now, second stanza. So let the wave wind up the hill or down. Over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. New friendship, high adventure, and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest. And hope the road's lost turn will be the best. Once again, listen the concept, understand the concept clearly, and then recite this poem. It will be easy to memorize. Thank you, students.